Good morning, everyone. Let me start with my introduction. My name is Balakrishna. I work as a director for Charm Health. Charm Health is US-based solutions where we have a very strong footprint across the globe, providing the complete clinic management solution for the healthcare practitioners, starting from the hospital, nursing home, and the bigger corporate hospital. Before I start, I just want to understand from you all, how many people are using the clinic management solution, or what you call as the electronic health record? Okay, very few. You know, today the objective is not to market about what is Charm Health. What I'm going to talk about is how this is going to revolutionize the next 5 to 6 years. You know, I've been in Delhi for the Health Senate, where few of the key decision makers with the Indian government of India are present. And we can vividly see down the line in 8 years, EHR is going to be mandate. For the simple, from a simple perspective, that 96% of the electronic the patient data in India are more inorganized in the sense of paper form. You know, with the Ayushman Bharat being effectively getting rolled out from September 25th, I think the more and more importance would evolve around the electronic health record to have the patient data, you know, irrespective of the clinic size or the hospital. So we just want to start with the Charm Health suit, what we offer. Next slide. Okay. We are an US-based company. As I told, you know, we are HIPAA type of compliant, you know. Today, globally, electronic health record talks about the security, and one of the critical factors is HIPAA, Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act. Everybody who are, you know, marketing electronic health record will have to have this compliant of HIPAA and ITEC. Means that is a license for you to market, to make sure your patient data are secure. You know, the patient data which are, you know, shared between the clinician, doctor, or the hospital to patient are encrypted. You know, that's a basic yardstick what the global standard talks about, the electronic health record. And Drumpen certification of meaningful use, it's going to aid the overall patient outcome. And we are subsidiary of Zoho. I'm sure that you all have heard about Zoho. Zoho is a SaaS cloud platform company, which is now with the 1 billion valuation, has got the complete footprint in Chennai. It's a Chennai-based company, and it's a software made out of India, made for the world. We have 7,000 employees working back-end, you know, developing the world-class software. We are competing with Microsoft and Google globally. Next slide. Okay, this is just prospective about Zoho. We are 22 years, we are operating in 130 countries. We have got 25+ applications, you know, and we have 5,000 people, and we operate from Chennai extension. Next slide. You know, today people talk about cloud. You know, more and more hospitals and clinics started using cloud platform because two reasons. Today, any hospital or any clinic or any smaller polyclinic having a server or the installed software is going to cost. It is a capex. How do you move capital expenses to opex? That's a critical factor. You know, so today many of the people are moving to cloud, and that's going to be the order of the life down the line in 5 years. So we are in cloud from 2005. You know, we have been now 12 years in cloud platform offering solutions across the you know, small and medium business enterprises. And the Medical Mind has a very strong footprint across globe, as I told you. Next slide. Okay, this is a general perspective. You know, how do you really create an excitement today? You know, I was into a conference last month in Delhi. You know, it was about the patient experience and the patient engagement, and every topic was against the nucleus of the entire healthcare is going to be patient. You know, so four to five years, any solution that need to be patient centric. So today, one of the critical factors is the connectivity between the healthcare practitioners and patient. How seamlessly people can improve interact with each other. How seamlessly the record can be shared within the people within the defined you know, whatever you call HIPAA and ITEC compliant. Next slide. Okay, this is some small statistics. You know, the X and Y axis. X and Y axis talks about the penetration of the electronic health record across the globe. You can see here, Denmark and Netherlands, which has such a small population, which can able to predict, you know, in the Netherlands and Denmark, people can able to predict some of the, you know, 6 months down the line, you know, epidemic, and they can able to, you know, chart out the action plans to make sure that the things are minimized. So there you see 100% of you know, healthcare being utilized to the maximum, where you have a maximum EHR option. And India and Indonesia, Philippines, which are the largest circle means the population, still we are at the lower level of penetration of electronic health record for various reasons. Next slide. Okay, and this is what, this is a PricewaterhouseCoopers study, which was published in 2016. Very interesting study. You know, it clearly talks about the when you move from the paper-based healthcare solution to a new digital digital healthcare that is going to directly proportionately determine the outcome of the patient. You know, this is an recent data. Next slide. And this exactly is going to be the Digital India Expert Adoption of Health IT. The goal is to collect, expand the adoption of health IT across you know, the states, and how people can be able to seamlessly share data, you know, from a hospital to patient or individual practitioner to patient or patient back to the hospitals. You know, and how we strengthen the healthcare delivery, advance the health and well-being of the individual and community. The ultimate goal of any digital electronic health record down the line in 5 years is going to be how do we really improve or aid the overall patient care. That's going to be the crux of the entire you know, digitalization. Next slide. Okay, this primarily talks about the ecosystem. You know, how an digital form of an electronic health record storage or the electronic health record usage is going to benefit the overall population. You know, particularly in a country like India, where you have 1.27 or 1.3 billion patients. You know, in US with 36 crore of population has achieved 100% of electronic health record. Today we are a long way to go. Down the line in 6 to 7 years, that's going to be the order of time, which is going to change the complete dimension of the healthcare in India. Next slide. Okay, today, you know, although we talk about IT, how our hospital infrastructure and individual clinic, polyclinic is going to adopt it. So any solution what we are going to provide in India, what the EHR want to do in India has to keep in this core mind. One is the market volatility. Use current technology and refresh often. Confidentiality of data. With India being the largest patient pool, you know, confidentiality of data is very, very critical to follow the internal regulations. You know, that is what the DISHA, which is going to get implemented next year, is going to determine. What I heard from the people, those who are working in DISHA, the IT, you know, security thing is, it's going to be more than IPAR IT compliant. You know, lot of essence and lot of elements is going to, you know, build in DISHA to make sure that the patient data is going to be the top priority. And innovation, how we identify user needs. You know, India has a different, you know, user altogether. Although we have a better penetration of the information IT or the internet across the major states, how you are going to make it user-friendly? Because US EHR usage is different. You know, people say 10 to 12 patients in a day, and they spend around 4 hours in you know, data keying and so on for the insurance plan. India, the complete ball game is different. We see average of around 40 to 50 patients, and the physician time spent is 2 to 3 minutes. So how effectively the EHR solution can be fit into an ETE to make sure that there's a win-win situation for the patient as well as for the clinician, and the integration with the existing IT system. India, you know, more or less people have their own installed system. You want to reinvent the wheel and invest again in cloud, or rather find out a solution that can be easily integrated with the existing hospital software or the individual clinic software. Next one. You know, so what CHARM offers? CHARM offers the electronic health record, you know, right from the patient registration, patient appointment can be done in reception where she can able to, or he or she, the front office can able to do only the appointments, and doctor can able to see the who are all the patient who checked in, and they can move into arrive, and then start the consultation note, including the images, everything can be pushed and pulled in. And then finally, signing of the prescription, which can be automatically sent to a pharmacy or to an you know, lab. It suppose any lab test is being prescribed. Patient engagement portal. This is something which CHARM has been very, very innovative. You know, today we have an electronic health record. How do you communicate to a patient? Say, for example, today there was a very interesting study conducted by PricewaterhouseCoopers in 2016 across all major cities involving 11,000 people. And one question what they asked is that down the line in 10 years, if you want the healthcare to do something, what is it you want to be, what is it you expect from the healthcare or the practitioners? One question is that I want to have a telecommunication. I want to have my data or the lab report or my, you know, pharmacy to come to me in a secure form. Means they don't want to waste the time of traveling 1-2 hours for the test, you know, after meeting the doctor. How the data can be integrated so that seamlessly the doctor and patient can be able to communicate. So patient engagement portal is one platform where doctor and patient can able to communicate seamlessly, sharing the data, having a consultation, you know, activating the telehealth, you know, if suppose it is a rural place, and so on. You know, mobile app and telehealth, today, you know, people are tech-savvy, and in fact, we are more than US now in terms of the mobile adaptability. So everything, whatever the solution which are in mobile app now, and the appointment schedule, next slide. So this is the customized service what we do, these are all the service what we do, next slide. So this is how the entire the workflow look like. I don't want to get detailed into that. I want to pass on one message, is that 8 years or 10 years down the line, EHR will be a mandate in India. And today you have a very limited internet penetration in Tier 2 and Tier 3 city. And with the Ayushman Bharat, the insurance coming in, the more and more awareness is coming in, the patient-centric healthcare is going to evolve in the next 4 years. Electronic health record usage is going to gain and prime importance in the healthcare ecosystem. So with this, if you have any doubt, kindly let me address it. Or thank you very much for the session. Do you have any questions? Anything?
It is
online, because this is a cloud platform. This can be accessed through the online. You will have to have an internet connection. It doesn't work in the offline. We have creating a mobile app. Say for example, if doctor is doing the consultation, the doctor can able to speak. It is a text to voice to text conversion. Like for example, the patient has been diagnosed with severe sepsis, been admitted for last 4 days, been initiated with second level, second generation, and my suggestion is to move to third generation cephalosporin or to carbapenem. That get automatically moved from voice to text. That is actually offline. And once that can be integrated, once the online is in place.
Are you using SNOMED terminology?
Sorry, sir?
Are you using
SNOMED
CT terminology?
Okay, ICD you are talking about?
Not ICD.
Okay.
We have got now SNOMED CT. It's a terminology which is used all over. So it is interoperability and...
Yes, absolutely. That's the advantage of cloud. It's an improv...
Are you using SNOMED CT?
Yeah.
Yes.
We have used ICD.
Yes.
See,
it's a global solution. We market across US has been widely used. We are now in India for the last 2 years.
Everything is there.
So we have an again, this is not a marketing session. What I would suggest is that Charm offers an 20 days trial period. You will have, once you are interested, you will give you a username and login. You can just use it and see how this tool is, and you can then if you are interested, you can just start using for individual clients. With this, thank you very much, sir. Thanks for the time.